What is this mysterious sea creature? A squid? An octopus? Maybe a kraken? Or even an alien? This rarely seen footage documents our discovery of a unique ocean-going animal that marine biologists spend years trying to observe in the wild. Graham explains.
We're in Tutukaka. This is our most favourite place in the world.
Well, look at it. How can you not like this?
Oh, the other night, well, we were going fishing and then it was absolutely shocking. Fishing's been really hard. And we're about to go home and next minute there was like this object which wasn't moving much. But it kind of looked a bit like a squid, like an eye. And then I thought it might have been a pufferfish. So I got my rod out, tried to touch it, and it went down. And so it disappeared into the water column. Well, after it disappeared for a little bit, we were kind of nearly packing up and I was keeping an eye out for this thing, and then it appeared again. And there was a bit of a wave was coming in and out, and as the wave came in and out, it got a bit closer. So I got right down next to the water and managed to grab a hold of this thing. And I realised it wasn't a pufferfish. And I realised it was a Nautilus shell. I remember as a kid going out to Mere Island, which is an island off Tauranga, Bay of Plenty, that these things would wash up on the beaches. Well, the crazy thing is, when I picked it up, it had an octopus inside of it, and I thought, what?
Graham tried calling his son, a marine biosecurity diver, to help us identify what we had found, but no answer. I guess normal people are asleep at 10 o'clock at night. Inside the delicate spiral shell, we could see some sort of creature inside it. The animal had tentacles and suckers. Was it a squid or an octopus? Both octopuses and squid squirt ink when they feel threatened.
Like a squid is inside it. Well, I was keen to get the shell because it was actually quite a large shell, and it's fairly rare not only to find a shell but to find one in such pristine condition, and this one was perfect. So yeah, I wanted it. Yeah, once I had the Nautilus there, I thought, well, if the Oki decides to come out, he'd soon find another hole to go and live in. So I was keen to keep the shell because it was a rare find, and I knew the octopus weren't endangered, and I know octopus, I've seen them on this island as I've walked around the rocks and the mud and the rock pools. They're everywhere, really. So they're not endangered. And I thought, well, if the Oki leaves the shell, then I can have it.
The shell we held was a delicate textured spiral with translucent striations following the Fibonacci pattern that describes an aesthetically pleasing arrangement of numbers that can be used to model the growth of plants, the branching of trees, and the creation of spirals, along with other mathematical and technical applications.
There's an eyeball.
Yes, this alien creature was watching us from inside the shell. And little did we know, the mystical creature we held was a rare and unusual observation. And while we were sort of on the right track, thinking it was an octopus, the story does not end there. Octopus suckers are not only powerful tools for grasping and manipulating objects, but they are also sensory organs that enable the octopus to explore and interact with its environment. Yes, they taste with their toes.
The shell's an incredible, perfect shell. So it is an Oki, isn't it?
I think so.
Well, it's an absolute perfect Nautilus shell. Anything like this before?
Never seen anything like this before. It's just incredible.
So what is it?
Oh, I think that's mouth parts of an octopus who's been using the Nautilus shell as its home.
No, it's a squid. It's an octopus. An octopus has taken over it. An octopus is living inside it.
Yeah, it's a squid. It's a squid. He just changed colour.
Octopuses change colour by changing the size and shape of pigment sacs in their skin.
Yes, there's eyeball. It's a squid. There's his eyeball. What are you doing, Alison?
What am I doing?
Yeah, what are you doing?
I'm videoing an octopus stuck inside a Nautilus shell. Are you going to touch it?
Do you do this regularly?
No.
Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Never seen anything like this before. Here we come. Come on, little Oggy, out you come.
We thought the octopus was coming out of the shell and watched in fascination while we were watched back. However, we soon saw something really special was happening.
As the octopus started to come out, I could see the remains of the Nautilus organism still living within the shell, and it looked like the octopus had moved in to eat it.
The thing's inside, it's eating the inside. The inside bit's still in there.
Of the Nautilus?
The Nautilus is still inside there.
But then as I investigated a bit further, within about a minute after that, he came out a bit further that we could see inside, and there was like thousands of eggs. And the eggs were actually attached to the back of the, like this octopus.
Yes, we then realised that these were her eggs.
It's laying eggs inside it.
This octopus was rescuing her babies and trying to drag the shell back into the ocean.
My desire for the shell was trumped by preserving the eggs and the little babies of the octopus. So we decided, well, it's going back in the water. So we had to work out how to get it back in the water.
Shell's amazing, but I think Oki's always more amazing.
Should we let him go?
So of course, we let her go free, back in the ocean with her eggs.
We had to work out how to get it back in the water. And as soon as he landed in the water, he turned bright red sort of colours with little spots and squirted out some ink, and he was ready to go on his merry way.
There you go, mate. Just drop him in the water. He's like getting smashed against the rocks though.
We were worried the delicate shell would get broken up on the rocks. However, Graham gently placed the shell back into the ocean, and with a squirt of ink, she jetted off into the night.
It wasn't until we let him go and we came home and we were like, wow, you know, what an amazing evening. You know, no fish, but you know, we got presented with this, with a shell. Upon Google, good old Google, we found out a bit more about it, that it's actually not a Nautilus, it was an Argonaut. And an Argonaut is a type of octopus that actually makes its own shell to lay its eggs in. And so we had discovered a shell that was actually having the live organism, which is the octopus, inside it, and it was laying its eggs and ready to reproduce. So we did the right thing and let it go.
While you may be familiar with the chambered nautilus that uses internal chambers to alter its buoyancy, these creatures are not found in New Zealand. Our discovery was, in fact, the paper nautilus or Argonaut, a very special type of octopus. The name Argonaut comes from the Greek word Argonautes, meaning sailor of the Argo. The Argo was the ship that Jason and his companions used to search for the Golden Fleece in Greek mythology. The paper nautilus was named after the Argonauts because of its supposed ability to sail across the water. The animal has a thin, white, papery shell that it uses to protect its eggs and control its buoyancy. It also has two specialized arms that have a webbed membrane at each end. Some ancient naturalists, such as Aristotle and Pliny the Elder, believed that the Argonaut used these arms as sails, catching the wind and gliding on the surface. They also thought that the animal used its other arms as oars, rowing when there was no wind. The shell is actually a secreted structure made by the female Argonaut herself. She uses those two webbed arms to weave a thin layer of calcium carbonate, which hardens in the water. She then fills the shell with her eggs and carries it with her wherever she goes. The shell is her brood chamber, her nursery, and her shield. It also helps her to float by trapping air inside. She can rise to the surface, take a gulp of air, and seal it in her shell, and then she can dive down until the bubble balances her weight. This way, she can drift in the water column without having to swim all of the time. If you enjoyed this special episode, please like, subscribe, and share this video with friends, scientists, or research institutions who might be interested.